Hey, welcome back to Java Tutorials. In this tutorial, you will understand what is loops, syntax, and types of loops in Java. In general, loops, something looks like this, means doing same task again and again. Instead of writing same code many times, we can use this loops concepts. The advantages of using loops in coding saves lot of time and reduce errors, and the code is more readable and understandable. For example, if you are printing numbers from 1 to 1000, it's not possible to write all the numbers from 1 to 1000, right? So in that way, you can save starting from 1 to 1000, print all numbers. So it's so simple. Now let's understand the syntax for the loops. We need starting point. This we can call as initialization. And ending point, this is like condition. Task means what needs to be executed. Increment or decrement. This one is useful for where to move, whether you have to go to next number or whether you have to go to backward. We already discussed this increment and decrement operator in detail while we were discussing about operators. There are three types of loops in Java. First one is while loop, second one is do while loop, and third one is for loop. For loop is very simple and handy, and we can also observe most of the programmers use this for loop. Now let's talk about types of loops one by one. The first one is while loop. The syntax of the while loop is, first we need to initialize the variable. This is starting point, I mean. Then we need to give the condition. If the condition is true, then it performs the execution of the code. In addition, we also give increment or decrement operator. This is pretty much the basic syntax for the while loop. The second one, do while loop, also similar to the while loop. But the difference is, do while loop first executes the code. We also have the initialization, means a starting point, then execution. After that, we'll give the condition here. After that, increment or decrement. We need to remember here one thing is, the code must be executed at least once here. That is the main difference between while and do while loop. Now the important one is for loop. In for loop, the syntax is like this. We have to give three parameters. The first parameter is starting point. Second one is condition. Third one is increment or decrement. If the condition is true, then we start execution. After looking these three syntaxes, upfront we can say this is easy and simple, and even while writing the code also you can observe that one. And for writing the code, it's easy to understand and more readable. That's the reason for loop is like handy. The next and important thing to understand is when to use for loop, while loop, or do while loop. For is used if the number of iterations is fixed. If you don't know like how many iterations we need to do, in that case it's preferable to use while loop. And if the number of iterations not fixed, and also if you need to execute the code at least once, in that case we need to take do while loop. This of course completely depends on the requirements. this is the basic and key information about for, while and do while loop. We'll talk one by one and we'll implement one by one coding in my next tutorials. I hope you enjoy watching my tutorials. See you in my next video. Stay tuned. Meanwhile, happy learning. Hey, welcome back to Java Tutorials. In this video, I will talk about what is while loop in Java and syntax, along with that coding example. The benefit of using this while loop executes the code many times as long as the specified condition is true. It saves time, reduces errors, it increases the readability of the code. The syntax of the while loop is like this. First, it initializes a variable or starting point. The next thing is it checks the condition. If that condition is true, then it executes the code. This is the basic syntax. Now we'll see the coding part. Usually, if you want to print the numbers, you have to print like this. So, this one prints 1. If you want print 2, again you have to declare a variable. And let's say n1 equal to 2, say again print n2. Suppose what if you want to print the numbers from 1 to 1000? It's not easy to write the code of 1000 lines, right? So in that case, we are going to use this loops concepts. This is the brief introduction about loops. Let's write the same example using while. First is initialization part. We need to initialize the variable, then while, and the condition. If you want to print, suppose up to 10 numbers, then print the number. So after printing one number, what it has to do, it has to go to the next number, right? That's the reason we are giving incremental operator. Save the code and run it. Now you can see numbers starting from 0 to 9. It's so simple, right, when compared to the previous one. It's not just for 10. You can give 100, you can give 1000, whatever you want, but the code is pretty straightforward. Got it? Now let's do one more example, printing even numbers using while loop and if statements. Let's take starting point is 1 and ending point suppose 100, while specify the condition here, start greater than or equal to end. If the condition satisfy, then write the statement start modulus 2 equal to 0. What does that mean? If the number divided by 2 equal to 0, then only print the number. What is the number here? It's the start. After printing the number, you have to increase this starting number using this plus operator, then perform the same task again until the condition becomes false. Save the program and run the code. Now you can see all even numbers starting from 0 to 100. If the divider is 1, then we will get the odd number. Formula is pretty straightforward, right? So these small examples makes us to understand better rather than trying to understand the big program initially. Hi viewers, welcome back to my Java tutorials. In this video, I will talk about what is do while loop and the difference between while loop and do while loop.
With some examples, the benefit of using loops are it saves time because it executes the code many times as long as the specified condition is true. The syntax of the do while loop is, first it executes the code once after initialization, then later it checks condition. This is the only difference between while loop and do while loop. While loop, it checks the condition and executes the code, but do while loop first execute the code once, then it checks the condition. Let us understand more while writing the code. This is the example to print the natural numbers from 1 to 10. After initialization, immediately we need to write the statement here. Print I. Then we need to give the incremental operator. Because we are starting from 1 and gradually it needs to check one by one. After the execution point, you have to give the condition. Save the code and run. Now you can see the natural numbers from 1 to 10. The code is pretty straightforward and very simple. If you want to print the numbers from 1 to 100, this is the same code. Or if you want to print the numbers from 1 to 1000, this is the same code. Or if you want to starting from 90 to 1000, this is the same code. Got it now? How easy and simple if you use these loops. Now let's try to write one more simple program for printing even numbers. We are starting from 1 to 100. This is the condition here. Before that, we need to write do statement. If start modulus 2 equals equals 0, then print the number. After printing the number, we need increment. At the end, we are giving the condition. This is the main difference between while loop and do while loop. And also we have one more difference. I'll talk that in a minute. Look, we got the even numbers from 1 to 100. The same output we will get it, right? Even while writing do while loop or for loop. What is the different thing in do while loop here? I'll tell you that. So, suppose if you give 1000 here, so obviously condition not gonna satisfy, right? If you run the code, still it prints 1000. The same thing if you can do in while loop or for loop, you're not going to see any result here. But do while loop, what it does, it executes the code at least once, even though the condition fails. That is the difference between while loop and do while loop. Hope you understand the concept very clearly now. Hi viewers, welcome back to Java Tutorials. In this tutorial, I'll talk about what is for loop, it's a syntax, and some coding examples. Using for loop, we can save a lot of time and reduce the errors, and it's more readable for viewers. If you use the loop, it executes the code many times as long as the specified condition is true. Let us talk more about while writing the code. The syntax for the for loop is very simple. It's just a one line of code. And that's the reason it is very handy, and most of the areas we can see the for loop code. This is a simple example to print the natural numbers. For open and close brackets, need to give the data type integer and variable. Starting from 1, and I is need to give the condition, suppose 20, I plus plus. If the condition is true, then this block of the code is executed. Save the code and run. Now you can see the list of numbers starting from 1 to 19. If you have seen my previous examples of while loop, do while loop, now you can feel like this is very simple when compared to those two. Now let's understand what is there inside for loop. This is initialization, means the starting point. This is a condition. I can also say this is ending point. This is incremental operator. You can also give decremental operator as well. That time it should start from highest point to lowest point. Now you can see, if you run the code, you can see starting from 20 and ending to 1. This is how the decrement operator works. Depends on the requirement, we can use these operators, frankly. If you go back, you can see now all the natural numbers from 1 to 20. Suppose instead of increasing 1 by 1, you can also increase to 3 points at a time. Look now. 1, next adding 3 points, next again adding 3 points, next again adding 3 points. That's how these operators work here. If you want to understand more about these operators, assignment and incremental operators, you can go back and check my tutorials. Hi viewers, welcome back to my Java tutorials. In our previous tutorials, we have seen what is for loop, while loop and do while loop with some examples. In this video, I will talk about how to use break and continue statements in the loops. As we know, these loops allows us to execute the code many times as long as the specified condition is true, right? But this break statement is used to jump out of the loop. Instead of jumping out of the loop, we can use continue so that we can break only one iteration. You'll understand once writing the code exactly what it does. This is some simple for loop. This prints natural numbers from 1 to 10. Let's run the code. Look, we will get the list of numbers from 1 to 10. Suppose you don't want to be iterate after 7. Without changing the main code, you can still write like this. Still, you can give the condition saying that I don't want after 7 like this. But without changing the code, we can use this keyword and write it. If I is equal to 7, break. Look, even though you are giving the condition go forward up to 10, but because of this break statement, when we reach the number 7, it breaks the statement and prints the 6. Sometimes we don't want to break the entire loop, we just want to skip only the 7, but rest of the stuff we really need it. In that case, instead of using the break, use this continue. Now you can see we got all the numbers except 7. But this and all for specific examples, or I can say specific requirements. It's always good to know, instead of rewriting the complete code, wherever there is a need, we can use it directly. That's all for today's video, guys. This is a very simple example to understand what is this break and continue keywords. I hope you enjoy watching my tutorials. Happy learning. Stay tuned. See you in my next video.